ओम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। ओम सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। ओम पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्बत्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणी। यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्र रुद्र मरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरासुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः देवाय तस्मै नमः। Yeah, so now you can unmute yourself. So verse number 38 onwards, everybody can chant after me. Sukha dukhe same kritva.
Sukha dukhe same kritva.
Labha labhau jaya jayau.
Labha labhau jaya jayau jayau.
Tato yuddhaya yujyasva.
Tato yuddhaya yujyasva.
Naivam papam avapsyasi.
नैवं पापम वाप्स्यसि। एषा ते विहिता सांख्ये।
बुद्धिर्योगे त्विमां शृणु।
बुद्धिर्योगे त्विमां शृणु।
बुद्ध्या युक्तो यया पार्थ।
बुद्ध्या युक्तो यया पार्थ।
कर्मबंधं प्रहास्यसि।
कर्मबंधं प्रहास्यसि।
नेहाभिक्रमणाशोस्ति।
नेहाभिक्रमणाशोस्ति।
प्रत्यवायो न विद्यते।
प्रत्यवायो न विद्यते।
स्वल्पमप्यस्य धर्मस्य।
स्वल्पमप्यस्य धर्मस्य।
त्रायते महतो भयात्।
त्रायते महतो भयात्।
व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धिः।
व्यवसायात्मिका बुद्धिः।
एकेह कुरु नंदन।
एकेह कुरु नंदन।
बहुशाखा ह्यनन्ताश्च।
बहुशाखा ह्यनन्ताश्च।
बुद्धयो व्यवसायिनां।
बुद्धयो व्यवसायिनां।
Today we'll be doing 42 and 43. So let's chant that also. यामिमां पुष्पितां वाचम्
यामिमां पुष्पितां वाचम्
प्रवदन्ति
प्रवदन्ति
अविपश्चितः
अविपश्चितः
वेदवादरताः
वेदवादरताः
पार्थ
पार्थ
नान्यदस्तीति
नान्यदस्तीति
वादिनः
वादिनः
कामात्मानः
कामात्मानः
स्वर्गपराः
स्वर्गपराः
जन्मकर्म
जन्मकर्म
फलप्रदाम्
फलप्रदाम्
क्रियाविशेष
क्रियाविशेष
बहुलाम्
बहुलाम्
भोगैश्वर्य
भोगैश्वर्य
गतिं प्रति
गतिं प्रति
बैक टू 42 यामिमां पुष्पितां वाचम्
यामिमां पुष्पितां वाचम्
प्रवदन्त्यविपश्चितः
प्रवदन्त्यविपश्चितः
वेदवादरताः पार्थ
वेदवादरताः पार्थ
नान्यदस्तीति वादिनः
नान्यदस्तीति वादिनः
कामात्मानः स्वर्गपराः
कामात्मानः स्वर्गपराः
जन्मकर्मफलप्रदाम्
जन्मकर्मफलप्रदाम्
क्रियाविशेषबहुलाम्
क्रियाविशेषबहुलाम्
भोगैश्वर्यगतिं प्रति
भोगैश्वर्यगतिं प्रति
So we were doing verse number 41. Krishna has just started talking about what he calls yoga, which we are calling karma yoga. Starting from verse number 39, he introduced, he specifically said, I'm going to teach you now about yoga. And first thing he says in 40 is that question about any action that we do, any pursuit we undertake, anything you start can be small act, can be small task, or it can be a huge project. Outcomes are not guaranteed. There is always anxiety about outcome. And so the idea that my effort will get wasted, my effort really may not give me what I want. Despite my best efforts, all these ideas will be there. So he, right away in verse number 40, he says, Abhikrama nashaha nasti, no wasted effort in this, in the matter of karma yoga. Okay? And pratyavayo na vidyate. So neither are opposite results produced. So this is a big, big paradigm shift here. I think you've noticed it. So because it is attitude, an action can have any type of results. He's not saying, now that you have started listening to me, I'm going to change your life and all your actions, you know, you'll get what you want. No, he says, he doesn't say that. In fact, he says, there is no guarantee that what you expect you will get. And the only buffer for that is karma yoga. And that buffer, once you gain means what? As you have that attitude, as you enjoy that attitude is going to be with you and it will never go away. That's what Krishna is saying. And then verse number 41 is what we were completing last class. Yeah. Vyavasayatmika buddhi. Very, very, very fascinating shloka. Fascinating idea. It's not unfamiliar to us. says you must be clear about what you want to do. You must be clear about, in fact, you must be clear about what you want. You know, so he says, be matlabi hona chahiye. You must be matlabi bolte hai na Hindi. Matlabi aadmi hai. Means everything he is asking, what is in it for me? What's in it for me? So what's in it for me? So here also he seems to be saying something like that. But it's even more important because it's about your own life. And it's not about getting this or getting that. Fundamentally, what is it you want? So having analyzed the Purusharthas, he's talking about Vyavasayatmika Buddhihi. So you, hey Arjuna, you must be clear about Purusharthas. And the Prathama Mukhya Purushartha, Parama Purushartha Moksha, you must be clear about that. That clarity is what is being asked for here. And that is called Vyavasayatmika Buddhihi. And Eka, there can be only one. There can't be multiple here. That one vision you must have in mind properly. And if you don't have that one vision, then Bahushaka Ananta Acha. Then everything seems attractive in this world. And you go after one thing after that, one thing after another, and keep on doing this. And karma has drishtapalam, adrishtapalam. And so this chakra constantly keeps moving. And no end to it. And then we will meet in all these parties and decide, what are you doing? What am I doing? What is she doing? Oh, this is interesting. That's very interesting. I never thought of this. You know, this goes on and on. These discussions, there's no end for it, right? So, oh, you're studying Sanskrit. Oh, when did you get that interest? You know? And then, not much to talk after that. You know, what big deal, Sanskrit? What are you going to get out of studying Sanskrit? You know? So, and then that's it, over. So, this kind of life will go on and on. This is what Krishna is saying. Bahushakaha, anantaha cha. So he's confirming what we suspected. Okay. Now, so here, the one thing I wanted to say last week was, so what about Arjuna? You mean Arjuna also was life like, he was leading a life like I'm leading a life now? Is that what it is? So, he was an ambitious man. All these fights with Shiva and all that he had. And of course, he's well qualified. He's a fighter and not an ordinary guy. He has all the mantras with him. And but he wanted his own for personal glory. Arjuna wants personal glory. So, Kshatriya. Not an ordinary guy. And so that glory is so important for him. It was important. So therefore, he also has been seeking like everybody else who is seeking Artha and Kama. He also wanted Artha and Kama in a dharmic way, in a righteous way. That was his life. Therefore, he also needed to be told that there is something called Karma Yoga. And this buddhi, Ishwararpana buddhi, Prasada buddhi, he had to be taught. So Arjuna is no different than us. So we are in putting ourselves in Arjuna's shoes. Yeah. So here the idea is simple. So when your vision is clear, you have only one goal. And your entire life is driven by that. And otherwise, my life gets frittered away. So if I miss that infinite Atma, if I miss the whole, then I will have infinite desires. Everything seems attractive. Okay, this is what Swami used to say in class. If I miss the infinite, I will have infinite things to do. There is no limit to what I can do. Assuming that free will is there, assuming one is in a situation where one can do anything possible. So there are a lot of factors in life which will constrain us from doing things. But absent those constraints, anything is possible. So we also saw karma yoga is something more than an ethical life. Not simply ethical life alone is not enough. Dharmic life, which Pandavas were leading anyway, that is not enough. Why it's not enough? Because the attitude need not be there. Prasada buddhi need not be there. Ishvara, I must recognize Ishvara as the karma phala data. These things are important. So Swamiji would say, there is no such thing as secular karma yoga. Secular karma yoga doesn't exist. Yes, karma yoga itself means recognition of Ishvara. Everything is Ishvara. Therefore, whatever I get is a prasada. That attitude I have to keep building. And it becomes my own as my knowledge also. As I gain knowledge of Atma as well. So that also we saw last time. So did I translate this shloka, number 41? Yes or no? Yeah. So I see one hand like this, and then I see one hand like this. So I can't make up my mind also. Okay. So some thumbs ups are there. Okay, good. So we have translated that. So, number 42 and 43 generally go together because there is a continuation of thought. And if you take those two together, the meaning flows well and the sentence can be completed also properly. So, Yamimam Pushpitam Vacham Pravadantya Vipaschitaha Vedavadarathah Partha Nanyadastiti Vadinaha Kamatmana Swarga Paraha Janma Karma Palapradam Kriya Vishesha Bahulam Bhogeshwarya Gatim Prati. Krishna is now telling about people for whom clarity is not there. And then clarities are not there, then priorities will become a problem. One cannot prioritize. What is needed, what is not needed. That kind of priority is not there. Cannot be possible. That is what he is saying here in this two shlokas. So we have to understand the society of those times. So Shankara has written this 2000 years ago, 2500 according to few scholars. I saw a report recently, a couple of months ago. So they were analyzing all the evidence available. And he's written an extensive treatise, 1960s or 70. And he's analyzed so much evidence that is there. And then he says, at the end of it, he says, it's still not conclusive whether Shankara lived in the 8th century or he lived in the 5th century BCE. That's what he says. There is still work that needs to be done. Okay. So many years back. So, that time it was a Vedic society, means all the people living were well tuned to the Vedas, and so they were governed by the Vedic mandates, and people were following samskaras, and they were doing rituals. And they were dharmic people. That society we must remember. Because he's going to talk about those people here. And he is now addressing the people who are committed to doing rituals. And not just rituals for the sake of bhoga. Enjoyment now and later. That is the type of people he's describing. Okay. So one can be committed to enjoyment. One need not be a Vaidika for that. Anybody can lead a life. It's like, what is it they say? Live to eat, eat to live. So what is it you want to do? Do you eat to live or do you live to eat? That question can be a big problem for some people. Live to eat. So this live to eat people are there and live to enjoy. That kind of people. So they're called avipaschitaha in the shloka, line number 1, 42, line number 1. Avipaschit is that word. Vipaschit means one who sees clearly, one who has clarity, one who is not confused, one who knows about what's what, about the purusharthas, all that is clear. That person is called a vipaschit. Okay. And he is talking about avipaschit. That person is a person who is avipaschit, means what? One who doesn't see clearly. One who sees some things but doesn't see everything. So there are holes in that person's understanding about what are the priorities in life. And so such a person is being talked about here. And in particular, they are Vedavadarataha. Second line, first word. Vedavadarata. So they are all very knowledgeable, in fact, of the Vedas. And Vedas means what? So 99% of the Vedas is all Karma Kanda. Karma Kanda means it talks about Dharma, it talks about Karma. Karma means Vaidika Karyam. So there are mantra after mantra. The Rig Veda is there, Yajur Veda is there, Sama Veda is there. So Rig and Yajur especially talks about what type of rituals are there for various ends. Means various things the human being seeks. And these people are very clear. Why they are clear? What do they know? They know that there is going, this Janma is a result of karma. They know very well that after this Janma, there is going to be Maranam, and Maranam is going, after the Maranam, there will be another Janma. And they know that after that, in that Janma will be decided by my karma, by my Sanchita karma and Prarabdha karma. They're all very clear about it. And they have mastered the Vedas which talk about rituals for wealth, for health, for progeny, like this, things that people want in general. Everything is clear. They are called Vedavadarataha. Those who are very knowledgeable in the Karma Kanda portion of the Vedas. They're not interested in Vedanta. They're interested in what? Last word of the two of the four lines. Bhogaishwarya gatim prati. Bhoga and Aishwarya. That is what they're interested in. Their commitment is to enjoyment and power. And and he gives some examples. So he says, Yamimam Pushpitam Vacham. And they because they are well read, they argue very well also. And you can't tell them about Vedanta. They will say, look, you have free will or not? Are you an animal? No, you're not an animal. Do you have free will? This free will, you have to use it. You must use your free will, right? Otherwise, what is there? You have eyes. Do you use your eyes or not? Yeah, I use my eyes. You have free will. You must use your free will. And you must, do you want security or no? Yeah, I want security. Huh? Do you want favorable situations or unfavorable situations? Do you want to enjoy life or do you want to suffer your life? No, I don't mind enjoying life. I think I would like to enjoy life. Mm-hmm. What is the use of life if you don't enjoy it? You know? Yeah, then what? And you must use it. And are you a Vedika or not? Yeah, I'm born in a Vedic society. Yeah, I'm a Vedika. I believe in the Vedas. Then what? Then do you know what all the Vedas offers you? You must use the toolkit. Bhagavan has given you this big toolkit to use. And all kinds of things are there. Anything you want to accomplish, it's all there. And you must propitiate the right devatas and get what you want. And not just in this life. Next life, in fact, there is so much said about next life. You better prepare now itself. Like we prepare our children for all these IITs and all that when they are 3 years old, 4 years. I mean, third class, fourth class and all that. So prepare yourself for next Janma. This is the way they talk. And they will quote also. You can't win any arguments with them. They will quote shlokas. What will you do? Suddenly in the middle of the Vedas, they will quote all these things. Swarga kamaha yajeta. Jyotishtomena swarga kamaha yajeta. So there is the Jyotishtoma yaga. You must do that. If you want to go to heaven, definitely, then you must do this Jyotishtoma yaga. And he will explain. He will give you the steps also. What are the things you need to do to prepare yourself? Because not easy. There are things you need. And some of these yagas can't be done by, people who are not wealthy. All this is there. And they are going to quote all these things. Pushpitam vacham. Look at that. Pushpitam vacham. Pushpa means flowery. Flowery words. Pushpitam vacham they use. You can't beat them in their arguments. You tell them, hey, if for a minute you stop and think, correct, I agree, you want security, you want to gain security. But suppose you're already secure. Suppose Atma is already secure. Have you given any thought to that? Then he will say, where does it say all this? Then I point to Upanishads. The Upanishads talks about it. What Upanishads? Upanishads are a minute fraction. A minute fraction of the Vedas. And Kena Upanishad, it finishes off in a few verses. Few verses. This particular yaga I will talk about, we will chant for hours and hours and hours it takes. Your Kena Upanishad finishes off in, you can chant it in just 5 minutes. You are telling that Kena Upanishad is going to decide who I am. Is that what you're trying to tell me? Like this they will talk. You can't argue with them. Pushpitam vacham. And that too, very flowery, very attractive also. They will say, hey, Indraloka, you don't want to go to Indraloka? There is a description of Indraloka here. Look at that. It's so attractive. You want to live in a big house here. You have big houses and all glittering inside. And that you want. Hey, Indraloka, you have to go to Swarga Loka. You don't understand. This itself you got because of your Purva Karma only. Otherwise you won't get all this. So they will say all that and they will attract you. Be very enticing. Yeah, why not? I think I don't mind having another Janma and go to Swarga Loka. This kind of idea you will get. Because their words are Pushpitam. Flowery words. Pravadanti. Pravadanti. In Sanskrit, Vadanti means they speak. Okay. Pravadanti means what? Prakarshena Vadanti. They're not ordinary speakers. And they're well studied, well read also. So they speak very well. Very well. And they will conduct conferences, they will talk about it, and they will say how they will find a way to systematize all these things and then solve it. Made available for you, my dear friend. So Pravadanti. These Avipaschitaha, these Vedavada Rataha, hey Partha, they are going to talk like this. And what do they say? They will argue Vadinaha. What will they argue? Na Anyat Asti Iti. There are four words there. What looks like one word is four words. Na Anyat Asti Iti. They will argue there is nothing other than this. Nothing other than this. Other than this means what? Other than going to heaven, going to Swarga. Why they, that's why Krishna calls them as the third line, Swarga Paraha. Swarga Paraha. Look at that. Swarga Paraha means what? Those for whom Swarga is the greatest. Swarga is the greatest. That is their goal. Their goal is this. Even if I suffer now here, I can put up with that. As long as I get Swarga in the next journey. That is their thinking. Swarga Paraha. Para means greatest. Most greatest goal in one's life must be to go to heaven after death. This is their thinking. And so why do they talk like this? They talk like this because they are kamatmanah. First word, third line. Kamatmanah. I'm saying line 1, 2, 3, 4 to refer to these verses 42 and 43. Okay. Kamatmanah. Kamatma, Sanskrit class students, Nakaranta Pullingam, Kamatman. So Kamatma, Kamatmano, Kamatmanaha. So these people whose essential nature is desire. It's not like they have desires. They have desires, we have desires, I have desires, everybody has desires. But then these people are just a bundle of desires. Their whole nature seems to be desire oriented. And pure enjoyment oriented. Artha and Kama. Dharma, of course. Artha and Kama. Because without Dharma, Swarga is not possible. Okay. So they are, that also they are recognized. So Kamatmana. Just embodiment of desires. Okay. And so they talk about these words, which are what? Janma, Karma, Phala, Pradam. These are all adjectives to the word vacham. The third word in the first line, vacham, is there. Vacham means words. They speak words and flowery words. So what kind of words? Janma, karma, karma, phala, pradam. So they talk about these rituals, these portions of the Vedas, which give you better births. Janma, karma, phala. Better births. They are hooked on to this better birth idea. They are completely hooked. And we kamatmanaha, they want better births. They're not, you know, what is the point in having another birth that is not favorable to you? So better birth is the key thing here. And so they talk flowery words, and what kind of things they quote from the Vedas? Kriya Vishesha Bahulam. Kriya Vishesha Bahulam. You know, I wish I studied Karmakanda. At least some portions, some yagas, this, that, and some details. Because we should know all those details. Kriya Vishesha Bahulam. They will quote varieties and varieties of rituals. Kriya. Kriya here means ritual. And how they should be done. Who is qualified to do these things. And how you should graduate. You know? And you don't do this yaga now. That's a little advanced. You must first propitiate. Don't propitiate Vishwakarma. Vishwakarma propitiation requires you to, do some basic devatas. You have to Indra and all you have to first propitiate, then only Vishwakarma, then only, like that it goes. And so they talk about these gradations, varieties, different types of samagris, and what kind of upasana you must do. Upasana means meditation. They are good at all this because the Vedas says very well in Kathopanishad also, Yama says this. You do the Agni Karya, you get Swargaloka. But you do Agni Karya with Upasana. You meditate on the Devata. Then you can get even more. Brahma Loka also you can get. These words are used, Brahma Loka, etc. Brahma Loka, gradation in these swargas, the different types of swarga lokas, gradation. Like this they will talk. Kriya Vishesha Bahula. Bahula means many. And many and varied rituals they talk about. And because Moghaishwarya Gatim Prati, these rituals which will yield greater and greater enjoyment, Bhoga and Aishwarya. Aishwarya is power. And he's going to talk about Bhoga and Aishwarya again in the next shloka also. So this is the vision. This is the commitment of these avipaschitaha, of these Vedavada Rataha. So they have an answer for everything. And so Krishna was lamenting about these people who are committed purely to enjoyment. And and they are very clear also. So they are the people who become missionaries and drag everybody into this and confuse everybody also. This is the type of people Krishna was talking about here. And so the sum and substance being, if I am not clear about what I want, then I will easily be carried away by such avipaschita, such people who are well read, they argue well, but they will drag me into it. So clarity, vyavasayatmika buddhihi is needed in order to make something out of this life. That is the idea that Krishna is communicating here. So let's go back to the two slokas and let's translate that. Okay. Hey Partha. Okay, second line, second word. Hey Partha. Pull that out. Then the non-discerning people, remember we are now using the word discern for vivekis, one who can discern atma from anatma. So the non-discerning people, avipaschita, who remain engrossed in the karma enjoined by the Vedas, Vedavada Rataha, okay, who remain engrossed in the karma enjoined by the Vedas, karma and the results, of course, comma, who argue that there is nothing other than this, na anyad asti iti vadinaha, second line, comma, who are full of desires, okay, kamatmanaha, third line, first word, who are full of desires, with heaven as their highest goal, swarga paraha, correct, comma, utter these flowery words, imam pushpitam vacham pravadanti, first line, imam pushpitam vacham pravadanti, okay, utter these flowery words, the talk of many special rituals, kriya vishesha bahulam, first word in the fourth line, the talk of many special rituals. Okay, I hope you're following me. Meant for the attainment of pleasures and power, Bhogaishwarya Gatim Prati. Okay. Special rituals meant for the attainment of pleasures and power. And of results in the form of better births. Janma Karma Phala Pradam. Third line. Okay. Look at that long line. So you want me to repeat once again? So translating this whole two shlokas, you will have, hey Partha, the non-discerning people, which means the people who are confused about what the lakshya is, who remain engrossed in karma enjoined by the Vedas, comma, who argue that there is nothing other than this. This means, of course, performing rituals for the sake of going to heaven, comma, who are full of desires with heaven as their highest goal, comma, utter these flowery words that talk of many special rituals meant for the attainment of pleasures and power and of the results in the form of births. It doesn't say better births here, but within brackets, better. Better births. So the message for us is, without clarity, priorities will become a problem. Without clarity, we will get lost. It's one thing to say, I want a child and have a child. But it's entirely another to devote one's life to going to a place which we don't know what will happen after this birth. Taking the focus away from this birth and putting it into some other place beyond here. This can be a big loss for the human being. Okay. So now, number 44. Let's chant that. Yes. Sajeev Mahodaya. Bhogaishwarya. Yeah, Sajeev, go ahead and unmute yourself. Sajeev Nair.
Yeah.
Bhogaishwarya.
Bhogaishwarya.
Prasaktanam.
Prasaktanam.
Tayapahruta.
Tayapahruta.
Chetasam.
Chetasam.
Vyavasayatmika.
Vyavasayatmika.
Buddhihi.
Buddhihi.
Samadhau.
Samadhau.
Na vidhiyate.
Na vidhiyate.
So is it my audio that's slow or Sajeev's audio which is taking some time, extra time? Just curious. All of you can hear me, no? Yeah, good. So let's repeat that. Bhogaishwarya prasaktanam.
Bhogaishwarya prasaktanam.
Tayapahruta chetasam.
Tayapahruta chetasam.
Vyavasayatmika buddhihi.
Vyavasayatmika buddhihi.
Samadhau na vidhiyate.
Samadhau na vidhiyate.
So, continuing that train of thought here, without clarity, without viveka, confusion is bound to be there. And there is no end to that confusion. So, let's see what Krishna is saying here. First, Krishna talked about Sankhya Yoga. So the nature of Atma, the self, which I didn't know before and Arjuna didn't know before, and Krishna talked about Sankhya Yoga. Then he said, there is something called Karma Yoga, and he's beginning to talk about Karma Yoga. Now when something is praised, you often compare it with something else. Something is praised, you compare it with something else. That's very natural. So here, Karma Yoga was talked about, briefly introduced, and we talked about A, Karma Yoga is an attitude, and why do you need that attitude? I need it so I can gain Antakarana Shuddhihi. I can gain this Viveka Vairagyadi, all that I want. And so that Antakarana Shuddhi becomes the goal of Karma Yoga. So here Krishna is comparing the Karma Yoga Buddhi to those who are committed only to karma. Only to karma. Karma Yogi also does karma, remember, does activity. Nobody can survive without living, without doing something or the other. So Karma Yogi also does karma. The Karmi also does karma. Karmi, one who is committed to enjoyments and doing karma for the sake of enjoyments. So he's comparing Karma Yoga to karma, so to speak. That is what he's doing here. So by comparing, we can appreciate what Karma Yoga does. So karma can be what? Karma can be Laukika karma or Vaidika karma. Vaidika karma is what? In a Vedic society, Vaidika karma is very important. So daily Nitya Naimittika karma is there. And so all the pujas, prayers we do. And Sandhya Vandanadi karmas are there. And Agnihotram, all these things are there. And in fact, a married person has a lot of karma to do. And together, married person, the couple has karmas to do. That is Vedic society, unique to Vedic society. And so there is the Vedic karma, Vaidika karma, and there is Laukika karma. Laukika karma means everything other than a Vedic karma. So going out, doing things, buying things, working, all these things come under what is called Laukika karma. The actions that are needed to make that living, make a living. There are Laukika karma. Need not be religious, need not be Vaidika. So that pretty much summarizes all the karma we do. And here, Bhogan Aishwarya, right? Krishna is again quoting, using that word, Bhoga Aishwarya Prasaktana. Again referring to the same people who are committed to enjoyment and power. Power. Aishwarya means overlordship. Power. You go out and you see, you look at this police constable. Look at the amount of power he has. Nobody argues with a constable. At least in India. I don't know about US. US at least you can go and say a few things and all. There's some conversation is possible. Here, I don't see that. You can't have a chat with the constable. Police guy who's standing there, and he's doing his duty, no doubt, and he has some Aishwarya, correct? And everybody, when he says stop, everybody stops. When he says go, everybody goes. He's a traffic constable, but not traffic means he's watching. So you're also careful. So look at the amount of power he has, and so he catches you. Catches you, brings, calls you. The minute a cop calls you, you know there's a problem. No cop calls you. I am happy you're driving you defensively. Sir, I appreciate the way you're cautious. And I noticed, you know, when somebody was crossing, two old people were crossing and you stopped. And no, we don't hear these stories at all. So when a constable, cop calls you, I mean, there is a problem. And then you argue and this, that, and you say, I'm visiting, you know, Coimbatore, you come and say, I'm visiting from the US. And you show your passport, US passport. And he says, okay, at best he will say, come, let's go to the police station. Because I have a guy who's bigger than me, I report to him. He's a sub-inspector. And you talk to the sub-inspector, all this passport and all, you don't show me. I don't know how to deal with all this. And sub-inspector, and there is an argument. Because it's at their time, you know, they have to, you know, nobody has been acknowledging their presence. So now is the time. So sub-inspector, you argue with him. And then after some time, he's tired. He says, okay, I will take you to the inspector. This goes on. So imagine, this constable on the road has so much power. You can imagine, inspector means what? And suddenly, the inspector says like this, why? You thought inspector is a great guy, but he is saluting somebody. So this assistant superintendent has come. Only an assistant superintendent. That means, you know what, there is an additional superintendent. There is a superintendent of police, it's called SP. They use the word SP here in our country. SP means not an ordinary guy. And everybody salutes to the SP. And then just when you thought SP is a great person, and he salutes another person, he's called the assistant inspector general. Okay, deputy inspector general, big man, DIG, called a DIG. And then he salutes another guy. That person is called an inspector general. Inspector general, you thought was a big thing. No, not a big thing. Because there is the director general of police, DGP. You can imagine the power they have. Just this, our policeman, our cop himself has so much power. He has a stick in his hand. I don't know why they have a stick in hand these days. I suppose you need a stick. And so anyway, so look at that Aishwaryam. This Aishwaryam is very intoxicating. And very intoxicating. That is why this Vikas Dubey, many cops must have saluted Vikas Dubey. So Vikas Dubey has no uniform at all. And still people salute him. And because that fellow became like that. These fellows might tell you, the whole system, they just eat up the system. So, degrees of Aishwarya, Bhoga Aishwarya Gatim Prati. Bhoga also is like that. No end to Bhoga. And you've got all the wealth you want, and now you've got, look at a big house, and many floors are there. And you got invited to by this man, and you go to his house, and suddenly you find there's no ceiling. And you look up like this. Oh my goodness. The ceiling is up there. It's up there and chandeliers hanging from top. And you're looking around and my God, I saw this only in movies. And this man is like this. And Bhoga, no end to Bhoga. Has everything. And for this Janma and other Janmas he has. But having all these things also, Bhoga may not be possible, you know. And you come, you welcome all the guests, and Amitabh Bachchan is there, everybody is there, and they are your guests. That means you can imagine, Amitabh Bachchan is your guest in a party. That means who are you? You are bigger than Amitabh Bachchan. That's what it is. And because Amitabh Bachchan wants you. And now what happens? Everybody is there, you're ready to enjoy. You go and then piercing back pain, not ordinary. You can't even stand there for a minute. You got to go back to your room, and because doctors are waiting there to take care of you. And then you do something, get some injection, and then you come out. This is a problem. All Aishwarya is there, cannot enjoy it. Very interesting, because In Kathopanishad, this comes out, and this dialogue between Yama and Nachiketa, young boy, and Yama is offered everything. He is offered Shatayushav Putra Pautran Vrinishwa. Ask for children and grandchildren, because children are not enough. I need grandchildren also. And so ask Shatayushav and Shatayushah, and they will live long. Ask for all that. Okay. And then Bahun Pashun Hasti Hiranyam Ashwan. ask for any number of pashus, cows and horses and things like that. Don't think, who will ask for cows? What a stupid person they must be, our rishis and all that. They're talking about cows and all that. Hey, without cows, this morning coffee you won't get, okay? So you better respect cows. Cows are very important. And then horses and all that. Why do you need horses? Hey, before all these machines came, these cows and horses, these are the people, they were the workhorse. I suppose that's why you get the word workhorse, right? That's what they had. And hasti also, elephants, he orders. Elephant. A man cannot maintain an elephant. Not possible. Because elephant, to maintain an elephant, you must be a rich person, wealthy man, to maintain an elephant. But king, remember, because Nachiketa was offered Bhumer Mahadayatanam. You ask for any kingdom, any kingdoms, even the entire earth you can ask. You can govern over the entire earth. So the governing means you need, because the enemies will be there. And so you need all these weapons and this and that, and elephants are all part of that. He offers it. But then at the end, Yama says, "Ka," because all this may be possible, but you can't enjoy. Just because I have wealth, it doesn't mean I can enjoy my wealth. That Yama recognizes, because Yama has a doubt whether this boy is going to fall for this or not. He doesn't seem to fall for all this. And so he's saying, Kamanam tvam kama bhajam karomi. Very interesting phrase he says. Hey, kamanam, all these things I have given you, which are going to give you pleasure, right? Tvam kama bhajam karomi. They can give you pleasure. But what if you have this piercing back pain all the time? Huh? Can you enjoy? You will be thinking of this pain all the time. And you will have to keep your hand like this. You will be constantly worried. When the pain is not there, you will be worrying about when pain will come. This is how life goes on, correct? So he says, Kamana kama bhajam karomi. I will make sure you will enjoy, thoroughly enjoy. Thoroughly enjoy. So that is how Bhogaishwarya Prasaktanam. These are the people who are committed to Bhoga and Aishwarya. Exclusive. Prasakta here means exclusive pursuit of Bhoga and Aishwarya. Pleasure and power. Pleasure and power. Those are the people he's talking about. And Tayapahrita Chetasam, etc. We will see that. Vyavasayatmika Buddhihi Samadhau Navidhiyate. So he says such people, they will not come to Vedanta classes. That's what he's saying here. We will see that in the next class, okay? Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.